Did you know that Chris Tapp is fascinated by felines? Because of the power, flexibility and elegance with which they move. Sounds also like a powerful woman. With this set, we are about to meet group 4 on this fantastic place called Estate Elswoud. Are you ready to meet them? Because here they are, Iris Borgman, Patricia and Neil. Welcome, ladies! Welcome, ladies! And ladies and gentlemen, we are now starting the head-to-head challenge with group 4. Iris, welcome. We are going to see your little video about the presentation of yourself. Here we go with her presentation video.
Hello everyone, my name is Iris Borgman. I am 26 years old and I've actually lived in quite some places already. I grew up in a village called Vledder, which is in the province of Drenthe. And after that, I moved more towards the east of the Netherlands, where I studied industrial design. And now I am living in Bennekom. And I started a job as a packaging developer at the company Friesland Campina. Besides working, I really like horseback riding. I do that with a friend of mine who has 3 beautiful Friesian horses. I also am a scout leader of a small group of children between 5 to 7, and we do a lot of nice activities. So I really like to be outside in the nature, and I really like our beautiful planet. So my beauty with a purpose is also around that. I want to fight the climate change and motivate people to take action. So I really hope I can inspire you to do so. Thank you.
Iris, what a nice video you have.
Thank you.
And I have a little fact for you, because ladies and gentlemen, Iris is already 4 years together with a boyfriend, very nice friend. But assume, Iris, that he would propose to you tomorrow. What would you do?
Well, first of all, I would be really happy if he would do so. But I am not sure if this would be the best time, because we are not living together yet. So I think as a first step, it would be nice to move in together. And then we will see, maybe a proposal would be in place.
Okay, but you would say yes?
I would definitely say yes if he would do so.
Okay, very nice. So that's something, ladies and gentlemen, we didn't know so far. So she's not available for another proposal. Neil,
hi.
Let's have a watch on your video of your presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy Neil.
مرحبا, أنا نيل الجبوري من العراق وعايشة بهولندا الجميلة. Hi there, I'm Neil Aljabouri from Iraq and live in a beautiful Netherlands. I was born in 2002 in Iraq, but didn't have that much luck because there was a war. I had to leave my family and everything behind and fled to Syria. After that, I moved to South America, and now my final destination, the Netherlands. As you can see, I'm a true multicultural woman and have been in touch with all kinds of people. I love fashion and the glitter and glamour that comes with it, and the confidence it gives me as a woman. Right now, I'm in my senior year and super close to fulfilling my dream to become a surgeon with my own clinics in and outside of Europe, which are accessible to each and every individual. I may be young, but I do not have limits when it comes to my ambitions and dreams. I am Neil Aljabouri, and I have to make my voice heard, my name be known, and my story be told. I came from nothing, but right now, I'm standing right here on my way to become the woman I aspire to be. A strong, successful woman who does the most to help men and earth.
So ladies and gentlemen, we now know a little bit more about Neil. And also for her, we have a little fact. Neil, tell us something more, because you're also teaching young girls the language Dutch.
Yes, I teach young Eritrean women the Dutch language. It's really important to find your place into society And that's also what I stand for. And the first step into integration is learning the language. And that's what I'm trying to teach them.
Very, very nice of you, Patricia. And we are about to meet her in her introduction video.
Hi everyone, my name is Patricia Korenrom. I'm 25 years old and I'm semi-finalist of the Miss World Netherlands competition. In my spare time, I enjoy doing sport and active activities in overall. I work as a pedagogical employee and work with children with varying ages from 0 to 3 years old. The two things that I like about my job is taking care of the babies and the responsibilities that comes with it. In my social circle, I knew several women who have experienced domestic abuse, what makes me sad. And it is underestimated how often it happens to a woman in our society. Not only in the Netherlands, but it's happening worldwide. So now I ask myself, how can it happen so often? Do you have the answer? With these questions, I will bring this subject more into the media to bring more awareness and find a good solution for a better world.
So that was the introduction of Patricia, and we are curious what her fact is. Patricia, welcome.
Hi.
Hi. So you have a little bit of a strange sport going on for a woman, which is called kickboxing. Why did you choose that sport and what is so fascinating about that?
Yes, I love kickboxing. It feels amazing when I do it. I get confidence and I can clear my mind. And I am fit and healthy when I do it. So it's the perfect sport for me.
Is it not a little bit a sport for a male instead of a female?
Yes, people think that. But a lot of women also do the sport. And yeah, you get so much confidence. And it's like team building, but you fight with each other. But it's a really nice sport to do.
Did you ever use it against someone that was attacking you?
No, I've never been attacked.
Well, for the future,
yes.
if you are on the streets and someone is trying to, I wouldn't dare with Patricia, ladies and gentlemen, just keep that in mind. Thank you so much, Patricia. We're going to see the Beauty with a Purpose round with Iris. Iris, you have a Beauty with a Purpose, which is amazing because you're do something about sustainability, right?
That's true, indeed. My beauty with a purpose is to motivate people to take action against the climate change. And of course, Miss World Netherlands is a proud ambassador of the United Nations. And the Sustainable Development Goal number 13 is climate action. So that already shows that it is really important. And I think that a lot of people are aware of it, but do not really know what to do about it. Or they think that what they do maybe does not matter. So I want to really show to people that what you do can really matter. And that even as an individual, you can take action and do small things to go against the climate change. And really change something.
Wow, that is really powerful, ladies and gentlemen. And I really, really wonder what new Her Beauty with a Purpose will be. So can you tell us a little bit more about your Beauty with a Purpose?
Yes, of course. Many young people with a multicultural background here in the Netherlands struggle to find their place in society. Although most of these people have grew up completely or mostly in the Netherlands. No matter how hard they try, completely blending into society is next to impossible. They keep facing racism, discrimination, and bullying. I was one of these young people myself, and I'm here to show them what is possible and how to reach for it. Everyone should have the same chances, and that's also why I'm ambassador of Sustainable Development Goal number 10, same rights for everyone.
They are amazing young women, ladies and gentlemen. I cannot express that enough. And we are going now to see Patricia, Beauty with a Purpose. Girl, tell us all about it.
My Beauty with a Purpose is about violence against women. And it makes me sad how underestimated it happens to women in our society. And it's with gender inequalities, and I think when gender inequalities stays, the violence against women stays also. So it's a problem what we have to do with all of the world. And 22% of the women in Netherlands have thought that they
are physically abused
by a partner or ex-partner, and 24% tells us that they are sexually abused by their partner or ex-partner. So it's a lot, and with COVID-19 it's also bring more and more, and I will bring more awareness to this. I think when I Miss World 2020-21, that I can bring the awareness outside and that we can look with each other for a good solution.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you see there's a lot to do on Beauty with a Purpose. Their projects are amazing. And stay tuned, because this is only the kickoff of Beauty with a Purpose, and they will bring a whole video very soon. But there's more, ladies and gentlemen, because they all have got a team. And this team for group four is education. I'm very, very curious what question they will have and what their answers will be. Iris. So, we heard it before, Beauty with a Purpose. Some of you already pointed it out, bullying is an issue. So I wonder, how can this be better addressed, Iris?
Well, of course, bullying is a really big problem, and it has a big impact on someone's life if you are being bullied. And I think that at schools there's already a lot happening. There are anti-bullying programs, and of course when something happens in a class, then a teacher can intervene. But I think what is forgotten a lot is that after school there's also bullying happening. It continues after school, so maybe some aftercare would be really helpful. For parents, it would also be helpful if they are informed more what to do, and also about cyberbullying, because nowadays children have access to computers and laptops and mobile phones, and they can bully other children via those things. So it would really help if people are more informed about that.
Iris just gave us advice for the aftercare. I think there's a very good key over there to take and to take action. So let's see what Neil's question is about education. Let's see, ladies and gentlemen, what Neil's question is about education. So Neil, what do you think needs to be changed so urgently in education?
Well, schools should not only teach students on the basic subjects, but also how to be the very best version of themselves. Students should be able to express themselves in every way, no matter what their background or story is. So education should give these students wings and not cut them off. And I think that's a part of the education where we really need to work on.
Yeah, and just support no matter where you come from. I know, Neil, you had a tough time coming into the Netherlands and with school and everything, but stay tuned. She will tell you more soon about that. We go continue with Patricia. Patricia, your question about education is rather good arranged in the Netherlands, right?
Yes, it is.
We have some things to improve, but in general, it's good arranged. What is the power of a good education?
I think what Neil said, I think if the teacher looks at each student and look what are their qualities and the talents and what the strengths are, that they can be being taught on their own level, so they can grow more than what happens now.
Thank you so much. Strong answer. Thank you. We continue because we have a job to do, ladies. We're going to see, ladies and gentlemen, which two women they choose. One out of the past and one that is still relevant today. Iris, I'm going back to you, girl. You have all been given a list with strong women from the past. You choose Marie Curie. Wow. Why did you choose her?
Well, I really admire what she has done. She was a pioneer in the field of radioactivity, and that also set the base for cancer treatment today. And at that time, it was really special for a woman to do research at that level, because she had a lot of barriers to go to education, to go to university, and those barriers were all laid in her path because she was a woman. But she overcame those barriers, and she did her research, and she came up with really nice achievements. So
yes, about those achievements, she won something, a prize.
That's true. She even won two Nobel Prizes, one in the field of physics and one in the field of chemistry, and all for her research dedicated to radioactivity. And I think that's really admirable. And she was the first woman to ever win a Nobel Prize. And she was also the only woman who won two Nobel Prizes.
Amazing. You did your research good.
Yeah.
And also, we have some women of now that matters at this time of the day. And your woman that you choose, she's quite one because she's from Belgium, ladies and gentlemen. And in my background, you all know, I'm from Belgium. So you choose Jeanne de Vos?
Yes, that's true.
Yeah. This Belgian sister left to India. Can you tell me what did she achieve there? What did she do?
Well, at first she went there to give lessons to deaf and blind people. But when she was there, she actually found out that there were a lot of things happening, especially in the slums where the poorest people live. And there was a lot of abuse among young children. And she wanted to address that. And she organized a movement to give those people more rights. And she made sure that the children could go to schools.
The job she has been doing, is that something that you are pursuing too?
I think it is really inspiring what she did, because she just decided to stay in India and to dedicate her life to all those people there. And I think that in my perspective of my beauty with a purpose, I would also really follow the same path, and also just take the step if I could.
And how would you handle that?
I think if you just get the chance to really change someone's life, then that is just something you should do.
Okay, thank you so much. Good answers, Iris. Proud of you.
Thank you.
We continue on because also Neil, ladies and gentlemen, choose two women. First one, it's a tough one, ladies and gentlemen, because she chose Queen Elizabeth I. Wow, Neil, what a lady you have been choosing there. Why did you choose her?
Queen Elizabeth was one of the greatest monarchs in history and ruled for 44 years, although she was third in line for the throne and a woman in a time in which the loss of succession favored boys. I think it's amazing how she completely did not fit into the standards of her time as a virgin queen, but managed to become such a great queen. And that's really inspiring. She shows young girls and boys that the standards don't, that even if you don't fit into the standards of our time, you can still manage to become someone great.
And what is the most special you feel about her?
Well, she was, of course, a virgin queen, but also said that she was married to her country. A fun fact about Elizabeth is that she wore her coronation ring on her wedding finger. I think that's beautiful and a way to unify your nation.
It certainly is. And do you think she's still an example to you and
yes.
to the youth of the time now?
Yes, of course, she's still an example because she shows us that no matter what your background is and no matter how different you are still capable to manage something great, and that's amazing. She's an example for everyone, not only for girls and boys.
Okay, thank you so much. Great answer. Another lady, which is very, very powerful lady, is Oprah Winfrey. And you choose this woman of an example of today. She's a woman of many markets. She's a TV personality, but she was also abused as a child. Is this something that is still relevant in this society?
Yes, it's still relevant. A lot of children go through it.
What would you do to give more attention to it and reduce the fact that children might be abused by adults?
Well, children have a hard time to express themselves in words, but what they can do is draw. So if we let these children draw their experience and their feelings, it's a great way to touch people and let them show what is happening in a subtle but touching way.
Thank you so much. And indeed, ladies and gentlemen, children are not that easy with talking, but they can draw. So that's a good point of view. Thank you so much, Neil. Patricia, Indira Gandhi.
Yes.
Wow. She done a lot for India. Tell me more about that.
She's a strong, independent woman. And I think she did an amazing job because she was the first and to date the only female prime minister in India. And I think that is a good thing as a woman in India, because the rights are there different than in the Netherlands. And she went to the war and she fought for independence Bangladesh. And I think that's an amazing job.
It is, certainly. A woman of today is Ingrid Staal. Again, a Belgian woman. Why did you choose her?
I think she inspires me because she wrote a book about domestic abuse, and My Beauty with a Purpose is about violence against women. So a lot of things that she was doing, I want to do for women who get involved with violence. And yeah, she's an example for me.
What do you think and feel should be changed so there would be less women abuse in the Netherlands and in Belgium?
I think we have to speak more about domestic abuse and about violence against women, because I know from several women that they told me that some people knew about it and there was no action. So my goal is to let the people see that when you hear or see something, that you can take action, and that this. And I think that step has to be lower to get some help from the health organizations.
Yes, indeed. Thank you so much, Patricia. So ladies and gentlemen, this was group 4, and what a fantastic answers they gave you. Stay tuned, because more is coming up and you will see very soon more about their beauty with a purpose. Thank you, ladies, and you did amazing.
Thank you.
Another fantastic challenge done by Neo, Iris and Patricia. Well spoken, ladies. We are happy to have you to help us sorting out and appoint a winner in each group. All the ladies are doing so much for Beauty with a Purpose, but also for their goals to be a good ambassador for the United Nations. Miss World is a stage for every young woman, no matter race, cultures or belief. As young women, it is a chance to ask for awareness and be a spokeswoman, ambassador for those in need. But it goes so much deeper than just be an ambassador or speakswoman. You must be capable to adapt to any situation and be flexible. As a Miss World, you are not only an example, you lead by example. It is an honor if you can represent your country and show the world your stage you have worked on. But enough now. You should get on your social media and vote for your favorites. There is one more group coming up for the challenge head-to-head. Stay tuned and stay with us because it's not over yet. Don't miss the episodes because this is only the start. And if you want to know who's going to be the winner, subscribe to YouTube and do not miss anything, any news, any update. Follow us on social media and you will get the best of us.